In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create this fun and procedural background loop. Hi, my name is Manuel. The background is all effects driven. The whole loop needs only two keyframes, and it is very easy to customize. Stick around for lots of tips and tricks along the way. Alright, time to dive in. This is our blank comp. We add a new solid, Command Y, color doesn't matter, and name it background. Then we head to the Effects and Presets window to add a 4-color gradient. Let's change these 4 colors into a dark purple, bluish gradient. The first one, dark purple. The second one, a slightly darker purple. The third one, slightly more blue. The fourth one, even more blue. Finally, we add a lot of jitter, which is like noise to avoid color bending. We add another solid, again, color doesn't matter, and name it Mask Level 1. And add fractal noise. Fractal type, smeary. Noise type, spline. Brightness, 39. Let's open the transform property and set the scale to 165. Complexity, down to 1. Next, let's animate the evolution. We set a keyframe at the beginning, then go to the end and set the evolution to 1x 0 degrees or 360 degrees. Then we open the evolution options and activate cycle evolution. And this option is exactly why we use fractal noise instead of turbulent displays. Fractal noise is loopable. It's probably too fast, so let's go back into the comp settings, Command K, and set the comp length to 10 seconds or 240 frames. Extend the two solids and move the second keyframe back to the end to frame 240. Let's add more effects. Next, we add levels. And move these two sliders for input black and white towards the middle. Or simply set the two input values to 125. All the blurriness is gone. We got sharp edges. Then we duplicate the background solid, name it Level 1, and change the colors. Actually, we need to solo the layer for now to be able to see what we're doing. Alright. First color, orange. The second one, a dark cyan. Third color, maybe red. Fourth color, a nice blue. And let's give the blue more space. Awesome. We use Mask Level 1 as the Luma Invert Mask for Level 1. That's the base of our background loop. We'll now add more detail to it. We select the two layers, copy them with property links. Option Command Y is the shortcut. And paste them. As you can see, all the effect properties are linked to the Level 1 layers. We want to adjust the fractal noise brightness though. We open the effect property and disable the brightness expression. Now we are able to change the brightness to 30, which increases the shapes. Then we open the opacity property of the Level 2 solid, disable the expression and set it to 50%. We paste the shapes again, open the fractal noise property, disable the brightness expression. This time we change the brightness to 18%. And the opacity of the Level 3 solid to 25%. And we paste them once more. Change the brightness to 6. And the opacity of the Level 4 solid to 15%. And one last time, you might guess it, we change the brightness to 1. The opacity of Level 5 to 10%. Awesome, enough layers. Looks like there's some interesting stuff happening. Now to change the setup, we use the two Level 1 comps. First of all, let's change the color. I want this one to be more red. And let's change the blue maybe. It changes in all the linked layers. Maybe you want the edges to be blurry. Simply move the two input points and the levels effect apart from each other. Scale it up or down or rotate it. And check out some of the other fractal and noise types. Alright, Time for some more fun. We copy the mask level 2 layer and paste it. Move it to the top and name it Glow. Let's make it visible and increase the brightness until the black shapes are really thin. In my case, it's 48. Then we want to invert the colors, so we add Invert. We set the blending mode of the layer to Add. Next, we add Glow and set the Glow Intensity to 2. We duplicate the glow effect and set the glow intensity back to 1, but increase the glow radius to 30. Awesome! To make it more interesting, we add Mosaic and set horizontal blocks to 192, vertical blocks to 108 to get square shapes. We activate sharp colors and move it above the two glow effects. Whoa! This might be a bit too much, so let's increase the brightness for less dots. Instead of using Mosaic, let's try Scatter. We set the scatter amount to 500, which creates some nice sparkly grain, and deselect the Mosaic effect. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and ring the bell to get notified when my next video is coming out. Thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate it. See you in the next video. Bye!